Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 16, Leçon U. And in this lesson, we'll see together one part of les pronoms relatifs composés. Okay, so it's quite important and it can be a bit tricky. So if you didn't really already watch les pronoms relatifs, well, I invite you to do so because it could be tricky if you didn't or if you have no clue about les pronoms relatifs. All right, so let's start right now with les pronoms relatifs composés. Okay, and well, actually, in this video, we'll focus on four things. The first one will be lequel. Then the feminine form, laquelle, then lesquelles, masculine plural, and lesquelles, the feminine plural. So lequel, laquelle, lesquelles, and then the feminine plural, lesquelles. Okay? And well, basically, if you want to translate that, I mean, these basic pronouns directly to English, you could use this which. Okay? So normally, if you want to use these pronouns, you can combine them with prepositions. So it's not a problem, okay? So basically, you will put your preposition, and after that, you will put lequel, then you will put laquelle, then you will put the plural form lesquelles, and the feminine plural form lesquelles. Okay, so it's quite simple. You just put your preposition, and after that, you put your pronouns. But of course, as usual in French, when it can be simple, well, we've got some exceptions. And we have two exceptions for this pronom relatif composé. And we're talking about the preposition, of course. The first one will be a, okay? And the second one will be de, okay? For these two prepositions, then it will be a bit tricky in a way. So we will start, if it's okay with you, with a. Okay, so let's see now, and if you combine the preposition a and your pronoun lequel, then you will get auquel. Okay, if you combine your preposition a and then the feminine form laquelle, then the good news is that it doesn't change and it's à laquelle. Okay, if you combine your preposition a and the masculine plural form lesquelles, then you will get auquel. And if you combine your preposition a and the feminine plural lesquelles, you will get auquel. Phonetically, it's the same as the masculine, okay, but well, you write it differently here. So, one example here, you've got the sentence or two sentences. The first one, je pense à une ville, and then the second sentence is cette ville est très grande. And well, as usual, when we're talking about pronouns, the idea is to try to avoid repeating parts, things. And in this case, of course, we've got une ville and une or cette ville here. Okay, so we don't want to repeat this ville. And the idea would be to, well, clearly merge these two sentences into one sentence. Okay, and of course, without this repetition here. So the important thing here is that you will have to first see and spot the verb penser, and then the fact that here you've got this preposition à. Okay, so remember, we've got penser à, but the good news is that we've got une ville, okay, it's the feminine, so if you remember this à and laquelle, it's not tricky. I wanted to start with an easy example, okay? So you will get your sentence and you will first start with la ville, okay? Then you put your preposition and the combination with the pronoun à laquelle, and you continue your sentence. So je pense here should be placed right here, okay? And you finish with this part here, est très grande. So I know it can look a bit tricky, but then you will get used to that, don't worry. La ville à laquelle je pense est très grande. Okay? So let's see now if we've got a masculine form, because that's the tricky thing. Je pense à un pays, and then ce pays est très chaud. Okay, so of course we have exactly the same situation here. We've got two sentences, we want only one, and then we want to avoid repeating un pays or then ce pays. Okay, so, and it's exactly the same situation. We've got penser constructed with a here. Okay, so it means that we will have to combine a and then lequel. And this is the scenario when it changes a little bit. So we first put le pays, first place le pays. Then remember, a combined with lequel is becoming auquel. Okay, so you put auquel here. Then, as we had previously, you just continue your sentence. So you put back your je pense. And finally, you put this part here to end est très chaud. And you get your sentence, le pays auquel je pense est très chaud. Okay? So, if we've got the singular feminine, we've got la ville à laquelle je pense est très grande. Then, masculine singular, le pays auquel je pense est très chaud. Then, feminine again, and then the plural form, les villes auxquelles je pense. And keep in mind that here, if you look carefully, because this verb, and it's here, it's être, is directly connected with the subject here. Okay, so it's les villes, the subject. So as you've got the plural form, then your verb here should be put at the plural form. Sont en Espagne. Okay, les villes auxquelles je pense sont en Espagne. And last but not least, les pays auxquels. So in that case, you've got the masculine plural form. Je pense, exactly the same thing. So you should put your verb here according to the subject, and the subject here is plural. So les pays, so it should be the plural, sont en Europe. Let's see now how it will go with the preposition, la préposition de. Okay, so, and as we had previously, so for the masculine singular form, de plus lequel, it will be tricky because it will become duquel. Okay, for the feminine form, good news, as we had previously, it doesn't change, so de laquelle. Okay, but then of course for the plural, then it will become desquel. And same thing for the plural and the feminine form, it will become desquels. So exactly the same situation, phonetically it's the same as the masculine plural, but then you write it differently because look here, you get this double LES. Okay, and so an example here, so same situation, we've got two sentences. The first one, j'habite à côté d'une plage. Okay, and the second one, cette plage est très belle. And then, well, as we had previously, we want to make only one sentence. We don't want to repeat this plage thing, une plage or cette plage, okay? And then we can see that it's quite interesting because we've got à côté, but then it's de. Okay, so it's right here, à côté de. Mm-hmm. So it means that you will have to combine this de and then laquelle, because it's here the feminine form. So you put your first part, la plage, okay, then à côté de laquelle, same thing as we had previously, the verb j'habiter should come back here, j'habite, and the second part, est très belle, should come at the end, est très belle. So you get this sentence, la plage à côté de laquelle j'habite est très belle. So, if we have now the same situation, but with the masculine singular form, so j'habite à côté d'un quartier, and then ce quartier est très cher. So, same situation, two sentences, we want only one, we don't want to repeat quartier, and then we notice that we've got here this à côté de. Okay, so we've got the preposition de. And in that case, of course, it will change because we've got this masculine singular form. So, le quartier, first position, then à côté duquel. Okay, so we keep this à côté de, and then we combine it with lequel, so it will become duquel. Then we put back our verb from the first sentence, j'habite, and then we put the rest of the second sentence here at the end, est très cher. And we get this beautiful sentence, le quartier à côté duquel j'habite est très cher. So, la plage à côté de laquelle j'habite est très belle. Okay, so in that case, you've got the feminine singular. Then, le quartier à côté duquel j'habite est très cher. It's the masculine singular. Then, les plages à côté desquelles j'habite sont très belles. So, same thing as we had previously. Keep in mind that here, at the end, you've got your verb that is directly connected to your subject here. So, it's the plural now, so your verb should be at the plural. Les plages à côté desquelles j'habite sont très belles. And then, les quartiers à côté desquels j'habite sont très chers. Okay? And same thing here, keep in mind that we've got here an adjective, and it's the same here, so the adjective should be, of course, directly connected to your noun. Here the noun is les plages, feminine, plural, so your adjective here should be at the feminine plural form. Same thing here, we've got cher connected to les quartiers, masculine plural, so your adjective cher should be at the masculine plural form. Okay? Keep in mind that if this pronom relatif composé will replace, remplace une ou plusieurs personnes, on utilisera le pronom qui. So it's a good news because basically if you want to use this pronom relatif composé, okay, so instead of a person, in that case you won't use lequel or laquelle, but you will use qui, okay, and then you will combine this qui with a preposition, okay. For instance, c'est une personne à qui tu peux te confier. C'est un ami sur qui je peux compter. La personne à côté de qui je suis assis est très sympa. Okay, and that's actually quite simple and it's a good news. So if this pronoun composé, ce pronom relatif composé, well, replaces a person, then in that case, don't use lequel or laquelle, but then use à qui, okay? Or, sorry, qui, and well, with the preposition, so à qui, and then sur qui here, and then à côté de qui, okay? So this is a good news, no? I hope it was clear for you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.